Welcome all of you students. Today lesson for each loop. Actually, in this lesson, we are talking about the concept behind for each loop. Right? We already know what is for loop. Right? Remember this thing. We use for loop when we know exactly how many iterations we want to iterate the logic, right? Iterate the content, right? The for each loop is the most important loop. The reason is in practical level project, in real world project, we don't know, the most of time, we don't know how many iterations we want to iterate, right? That is the most important part. Most real world application, we get data from database or call some services, right? In that way, most of time we don't know how many iterations we have, but we know that must be a collection of data. Right. Use for each loop iterating through all the elements from that collection. Collection mean it will be an array, it will be a list, right? More collection type also there, but still we are not focusing that thing, right? Okay. This is my previous example, right? That example, I create console lab project and few classes, right? Don't worry about this. I'm adding one more class to this example called for each example, right? Remember this thing. We use for each loop for iterating through the collection, right? Think about this. Your collection has 20 elements, 40 elements, or 100 elements, 1000 elements, right? You can iterate through the number of elements in the collection, right? Collection means it will be an array, it will be a list, or like that, right? Right. I make a class and make method, create a method, example called void type method, right? Now I want to introduce you to for loop with arrays and list, right? This time the most of the in a real world scenario we use list, right? The data comes with list, not array. But when user learn programming, the most of the time they use list of the type we should keep, integer or array, string or whatever, right? I use string, we use name, new list of string, capital string, and right, you can see this thing also, right? Capital string and simple string both will available. Reason is your C sharp program comes with .NET framework also, right? This simple string comes with C sharp and capital string with capital S comes with .NET, right? Both will work, but I use this one. Don't worry, right? I just create a list type, create a list type of string type, and list name is names, right? Now I want to add names dot, you can add string name, any This way, your list has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 elements. Right? You can add any number of elements to this list. Right? It's no problem. Right? Now I want to iterate the content inside this list. Right? Now I use for each loop. Select and click 2 times on tab key. Right? This is the, you can give your own name. I keep this item. I want iterate this name. Right? This also you can use debugging and how this work. Right? Now I use console dot write line with not this item. Item mean this is your collection. This will be an array, this will be a list, right? This is the one item. Mean it will be this one. It will be this one. Right? Get one by one and print that value. Right? I create a new class and create a method. Right? Now I want to go to main method. Main method in program.c#. Right? Remove this thing. Create object from class. Give object name. You can use any name. Create an object and access your name with that object. Right. Example. And use console.writeline. Also, reason is I want to save my console. Right. Okay, I use debug point, right? Check that. Use this key, this one OF10, one by one. Click here, you can see 7 items are there. 7 mean 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? 7 items in this, I don't know. Now this is the A. A mean first value, right? Go to click some F10. Now check. Now your item will be DDD. DDD mean now you are in this, right? This is the way, right? Right. If I use a this example code, I make one more method and hide this one, example code 2. Okay. This time I want to explain this with array, how we use arrays. String at arrays create this way. String type names, new string and value also assigned in same time. Right, give some can give your own any meaningful name is good, right? I just use some string. Right. This also we use name. This time we call this type of thing as array, right? Now I want to call this method with object from this class, right? Now I call to this method, change the method and run your project. You can see array also work, right? Think about this. You know the for loop, right? Not for each loop. Actually, when you learn programming, most of the time you practice with for loop. The reason is still you are learning, right? You exactly know your data set. You know how many iterations are there, right? That's why we, as a beginner, we always use for loop, right? But when you comes to the industry with real world project, real world and running database and call services, right? Most probably you can't use for loop. The reason is we don't know how many items are there, right? It will change. That time you have to use for each loop. Actually, in myself also, we heavily use this for each loop, right? Think about this. We use collection. Collection mean it will be there are different kind of collection types, right? Those are we'll talk about later lessons, right? That part is the most important part, and but I will cover all the things with practicals, right? Not only theoretical. In this time, remember this thing: we use this for loop for iterating through the elements, right? We don't need to care about how many items are there, right? It also work as for loop, but this time we don't need to consider how many items are there, right? Okay, that's the thing I want to explain with for each loop, right? Okay, that's it for this lesson. Let's move into next part.